Decided to play doctor, said the American people were suffering from some kind of malaise. Well, in November 1980, you gave them a message. You said, physician, heal thyself. And every one of you here proved it wrong and showed them there's no greater engine for change and economic growth and prosperity than the hard-working men and women of the United States of America.
January, I'll be going home. Thank you.
White House to the State House to the county seat, and make sure that everybody who sh- I thought you might say that. Okay, now let's talk about school prayer. We're for it, they're against it. I want to ask for him, who's on your side? Are the liberals or is it the Republican ticket? Inch of ground on this good earth has fallen to the communists. We're also on your side because we take the threat of crime seriously. We've appointed serious-minded judges who respect the Constitution.
There are no citizens more precious than the men and women who guard us, our state and local police, and we must stand united.
Them as they protect us. And that's why we believe with all. Let me tell you, the president can't spend a dime. Only Congress can spend. In those 50 years, 46 of them with the Democrats in control of both houses of the Congress, there have only been 8 scattered years of that half century. When the Democratic president then had started his war on poverty, which poverty won. In those 15 years, the budget of the United States government increased 5 times what it had been. And the deficit of warehouses with office furniture in them, because the only way they know sometimes to spend up the surplus is to buy new furniture. But then we came into office in 1981, and for 6 years we had one house, the Senate, on our side.
Based of all, not for 10 or 15.
Between 86 and now, we have cut the federal deficit by some $70 billion. We're continuing on a path of cutting. But thank you.
Well, all you linemen would be happy to know. That zero pass there that he just threw it, we all know that we could do that. I was a right guard. As a matter of fact, I got to tell some football story, haven't I? But when I got out of school after 8 years of high school and college football, I wanted to be a sports announcer. And I started calling on radio stations and asking and so forth. And finally, I got to a station in Davenport, Iowa. The program director, he didn't have any place, and I started out myself aloud. I said, how do I ever get to be a sports announcer if I can't get a job at a radio station? And this was the depths of the Great Depression, and I went down the line to the elevator. Fortunately, he wasn't there, because then I heard him bumping down. He was somewhat lit up what was coming. When he got closer, he said, what was that you said about sports? I said, well, that's what I want to be. He says, you know anything about football? He said, I played it 8 years. He said, could you tell me about a game and make me see it if I was sitting home listening to the radio? I said, I think so. He took me in a studio, stood me in front of a microphone. He said, when the red light goes on, if you're in here alone, I'll be in another room listening. You broadcast an imaginary football game. Well, I stood there and I thought, what am I going to do for names? And I thought, wait a minute. I'll just say, we won a game in the last 20 seconds of the previous season. And I was still playing. Quarterback carried the ball and off tackle smashed it down the sideline 65 yards for a touchdown. Well, I knew enough of the other team's players, and I knew all our players, so I said, wait a minute, I'll start this imaginary broadcast in the fourth quarter. Now, right guard, which I don't know what you do in these days, but in those days, right guard used to pull out and run interference. In fact, on that particular play, I was the key. I got the first man in the secondary for him to cut back and go through. And in the game, I don't know how he ever made the touchdown, because I must stop my But I want to tell you that in the arena, when I broadcast for him in that other room, I delivered a block that was earth-shattering. I got even through it with everything. Then, of course, playing a Gipper by next was also something for us linemen to do. Try that.
How do you think you're doing on this campaign?
What?
I think we're going to take a team photo now with the president, all right?
What do you like in the Super Bowl? Running back, he's down in the front.
Do you need something to go up on?
Come back, guys. Come on.
Where's the Q? Where's Bob Lynn?
She wanted to get a field goal?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Always outweighed.
Frankie?
Mr. President, we want you to run again in 96.
We'll change the law.
There you go.
Thank you for coming.
Just hold over this side,
please. Yeah, first ball out. Back up. First ball's been thrown out.
77 line, President.
I hear Dude of Shooter.
Drop it, Jeff.